Hi everyone, my name is Carissa Disassembly and I work on the device repair engineering team at Microsoft. Today, we're going to be disassembling the new Surface laptop and I'll be highlighting the repairability features on one of our most repairable Surface devices. I'm going to demonstrate at a high level how to disassemble and reassemble the replaceable components. But before attempting repair, please consult the detailed instructions and follow the safety guidelines in the Surface laptop service guide that is posted on the Microsoft support website. All repairs should be performed on an ESD-safe surface with grounding to protect the device. Also, please remove all jewelry, like watches or rings. All you're going to need to fully disassemble the device is a plastic spudger, plastic opening pick, a pair of plastic tweezers, and a 2IP, 3IP, 5IP, and 6IP Torx Plus screwdriver. With that, we can get started. First, ensure the battery is fully discharged and the device is shut down through the Windows system. Flip the device over and orient it with the display side face down and the feet facing up. We're going to start by removing the feet by carefully prying them up with a plastic spudger. The feet on this Surface laptop are designed to be reusable. Now with the feet removed, we're going to start working on the bottom cover. There are four screws under the feet and you don't want to try to pull off the bottom cover until all these are removed. We'll be using a 5IP Torx Plus screwdriver and we recommend that you count screws and place them away from your device as you go along. This is to ensure that there will be no loose screws remaining inside your device when it comes time to reassemble it. We want to avoid causing any possible damage to the battery or to avoid creating any other unsafe conditions. Now we can separate the bottom cover from the device using a plastic opening pick. Insert the pick into the space between the bottom cover and the keyboard assembly and carefully lift the bottom cover off the device. The next step is to remove the SSD, which will shut down power to the whole system. To do that, remove the tape from the SSD and then use a 5IP screwdriver to remove the screw. As you unscrew and remove this component, please do not use any sharp tools and be mindful of dropping any screws. So although we can easily repair a variety of components at this point, today we'll start with the battery. First, we're going to be removing the bracket on the battery connector using a 3IP screwdriver. Now we can disconnect the battery connector from the motherboard. Next, we will remove 8 battery screws using a 5IP screwdriver. I want to recognize the amazing job by the team to make this device so repairable. Notice that all of the connectors, speakers, fan, and battery are removable without any glues or hidden adhesives. We really wanted to focus on being able to do the right size repair and get you back up and running as soon as possible. As you remove the battery, make sure that you handle the battery from the four points here and carefully lift the battery out. Only handle the battery by the plastic frame. Place the battery somewhere where the battery cannot accidentally be contacted or damaged. The battery should not be discarded in the municipal solid waste stream and must be managed per applicable disposal laws along with all waste residuals of the repair process. Next, we'll remove the display module. For this, we'll need a 6IP and a 3IP screwdriver and a plastic spudger. We'll start by removing the audio jack bridge using a 3IP and 6IP screwdriver. Next, we're going to remove the antenna assembly. To do this, we first need to remove the coax cable lids using a plastic spudger. Next, we'll disconnect the two coax cables from the motherboard. Then, we will remove 12 screws on the antenna assembly using a 3IP screwdriver. Next, we will remove the shield on the motherboard that is protecting the display module connectors. You can remove the screw closest to the motherboard if it makes it easier for you to access. Once the shield is removed, we can disconnect the display module connectors from the motherboard. Now to continue, open the display assembly to 90 degrees and place the back side of the display assembly down with the screen facing up. Next, with one hand holding the device, use a 6IP screwdriver to remove the 7 remaining hinge screws. Carefully lift the keyboard assembly from the display assembly to remove it. Now we'll move on to the Surface Connect port. Remove 2 screws using a 3IP screwdriver. Using a spudger, flip up the latch on the motherboard and disconnect the Surface Connect port connector from the motherboard. Gently peel up the PSA under the Surface Connect cable on the fan and clean with IPA. Remove 2 screws using a 3IP screwdriver for the left speaker and 2 screws for the right speaker. Next, remove the speaker tape. To remove the speaker connectors from the motherboard, pull up vertically on the wire until the connector comes free. Now, we'll remove the audio jack by removing 1 screw using a 3IP screwdriver. Disconnect the audio jack connector from the motherboard. Now we'll remove the fan by removing 3 screws using a 3IP screwdriver. Disconnect the fan connector from the motherboard. Now we'll remove the motherboard. First, we need to remove 1 shield to get to the motherboard screws underneath. Next, we need to disconnect the keyboard connector, the touchpad connector, and the keyboard backlight connector from the motherboard. First, we need to remove the tape from the touchpad connector and clean with IPA. Then, we will remove the small steel bracket on the motherboard using a 3IP screwdriver. Now, we can remove the 10 screws on the motherboard, still using that 3IP screwdriver. With all 10 screws removed, we can now gently remove the motherboard. Make sure that no connectors are still attached. Using both hands, carefully lift the motherboard out and up. The next process is needed for keyboard replacement only. For this repair, you will need to remove the mounting brackets on the keyboard using a 2IP screwdriver. And with that, we finished disassembly of the new Microsoft Surface laptop. Now we will reassemble the device. When reassembling, always count your screws, especially those near the magnets or the battery pack. First, we begin by installing the mounting brackets on the keyboard. Install the mounting brackets to the keyboard assembly using a 2IP screwdriver. We provide new screws with our repair parts, and these should be used during reassembly. When you install the motherboard, make sure you lift the keyboard, touchpad, and keyboard backlight connectors out of the way so that they do not get stuck underneath the motherboard. Once the motherboard is in place, plug a USB-C cable or drive into one of the USB-C ports while holding the motherboard steady with your left hand. Install all 10 motherboard screws using a 3IP screwdriver. Now, remove the USB-C cable. Install the small bracket on the motherboard with a 3IP screwdriver. Connect the keyboard, touchpad, and keyboard backlight connectors to the motherboard. To do this, confirm that the latch on the motherboard connector is in a vertical position before inserting the connector. Once the connector is inserted, flip the latch on the motherboard down to secure the connector. If you're reusing the motherboard, make sure to clean off the blue thermal grease from these 2 components. Apply new thermal grease. Install a new shield to the motherboard. Now we need to add new tape to the touchpad connector. Next, we'll install the fan using three 3IP screws. Install the fan connector to the motherboard and secure the latch. Next, we'll install the speakers. Install the speaker connectors into the receptacle on the motherboard by pressing vertically until a snap is felt. Route the left speaker wire. Install new speaker tape. Install two 3IP screws to the left speaker and two 3IP screws to the right speaker. Next, we'll install the Surface Connect port. First, we'll install new PSA on the fan. Install the Surface Connect port with two 3IP screws. Insert the connector of the Surface Connect cable into the receptacle on the motherboard and close the latch to secure it. Now we'll install the display module. Place the back side of the new display assembly down with each of the hinges set at 90 degree angles. Carefully align the hinges into the pockets on the keyboard assembly. Pre-fasten seven new hinge screws using a 6IP screwdriver. Next, we need to check alignment. Close the device and then loosen the seven hinge screws about 90 degrees for a quarter turn. Adjust the alignment until the gap between the display assembly and the keyboard assembly is as even as possible. Tighten down one screw on the right hinge. Loosen the screw that was tightened down on the left hinge. Adjust the left side so that the keyboard assembly surface is flush with the display assembly. Repeat as necessary until the left and right gaps are even and the back surfaces are flush. Connect the display connectors to the motherboard. Tighten all seven hinge screws. Next, we'll install the connector shield. Now, we'll install the audio jack with one 3IP screw. Install the audio jack connector to the motherboard and secure the latch. Next, we'll install the antenna using 12 3IP screws. So this is one where I'm not securing them down all the way. I'll come back and kind of secure them all down. I'm going to tighten them up, going back in and securing all these. But the reason I do this is because these are super small screws, and sometimes the alignment gets all wacky if you tighten one too early. Connect the two coax cables to the motherboard by aligning each with the socket and pressing down until a click is felt. Install two new coax cable lids to the motherboard over the coax cables. Next, we'll install the audio jack bridge with one 6IP screw and two 3IP screws. Next, we'll install the battery. Before installing the battery, be sure to verify the battery's condition and confirm there's no damage. If you're installing a new battery, use the plastic loops. If reinstalling a battery, pick up from these four points. Only handle the battery by the frame. Make sure not to bend it or twist it. Always use two hands when handling the battery. Install eight new battery screws with a 5IP screwdriver. Now connect the battery connector to the motherboard. Install battery bracket with two 3IP screws. Next, we'll install the SSD with one 5IP screw. Install SSD tape on the SSD connector. Next, place the spacer on top of the tape with the dot towards the top of the device. The spacer should be placed next to the flange and centered on the SSD connector. Before installing the bottom cover, check for any unexpected items within the device. Using both hands, Carefully lower the bottom cover onto the device. Install 4 new screws to the bottom cover using a 5IP screwdriver. Now you can install the feet. Thank you for your time, and I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, you can find more detailed instructions in the service guide available on the Microsoft website.